Welcome to the Before and After series, where I'm reworking designs prepared by novice UX and UI designers with intention of improving them. Today I've prepared for you an example of mobile app design screens from the medical industry. Let's start with the first screen. As in previous videos, I will give you a moment to spot and think about the differences. From the first glance, you probably noticed that the biggest change is around the color. That's something I have talked about in my video about colors in user interface design. And here we can see the prime example of very vivid, exciting, and energetic primary color that fails all accessibility and usability standards. I used the original color as a base and generated a new palette out of it that meets WCAG contrast standards. As you can see, now you can actually read the text. Next big thing is the inputs, which on the original design look more like buttons and don't indicate their purpose. As a general rule, I would recommend for all of you to never make text inputs bigger in size than actual buttons. Good practice is to unify their height and shape to make them more compatible with each other. Then, apart from their style, we have an issue of their position that it's not very optimal for the real usage. Most of us, in most cases, tend to use our smartphones by holding them in one hand. That means all crucial functionalities should be reachable by our thumbs. In the original design, the position of the input fields is very much out of reach for the thumb. So we would have to master our second hand or hold the phone in a very awkward manner. Apart from that, I have used empty space on my redesign to provide something more visually appealing to the potential user in a form of an illustration. Let's move to the next screen. Again, I will give you a moment to spot out the differences. I think that the issue with the input fields is even more visible on this one. Apart from the reasoning from the previous screen, I want to focus your attention on the lack of space for input labels and validation on the original design. Potentially the intent of the author here was to move the label to the top of the field once selected, but then again, potential validation of the fields may look very awkward since it would also need to take place inside it. Next thing that is very much off are the sizes of some UI elements. You will see this especially on the next screens, but on this one, you can see that the go back button is weirdly out of scale in comparison to other elements. Same thing applies to the font sizes. Remember that in the real-world applications, those elements need to be readable and visible to the user on their phones. If you aren't sure about what size that element should be, try to export that screen as a flat image and view it on a dedicated device in full screen. If you don't have that option, try to put that screen on device mockup to get a better grasp of the scale. Apart from that, I have also included an illustration for this screen as well. Let's move to the third screen. Try to spot already mentioned changes and recall reasoning behind them. As I mentioned, at this screen, you can see how inappropriate sizes can negatively affect accessibility of our interfaces. Those elements are just too small and they feel like they are out of place. Next, we have some missing icons. I'm assuming that it's not the original intent, but maybe a software error. Then we have those colorful icons that resemble simple illustrations. They work very well for things like category items, but functional elements of the interface, like navigation, work better when they are simpler. That way, we are achieving a distinction between actionable elements of our interfaces from the content part of it. Apart from that, you can notice some alignment and stylistical changes, especially around the rounded corners that look a bit weird on the original design. I also added some more categories to the design, because I assumed that an application like this would have more than four of them. I mentioned this on my other videos. As you can hear, I'm not a native speaker, but please be mindful about the language and double check your spelling. Let's move to the fourth screen. I followed with most of the changes that I already covered on the previous screens. So we have issues with the scale, visibility and readability problems due to poor contrast and some language issues. Apart from that, I replaced the lorem ipsum filler text with a more realistic one. Remember that it's a dead giveaway that the design is fake. And whenever you are presenting your work, it looks more professional when you use something more believable. Last thing is the introduction of the gradients at the bottom of the screen to provide better visibility for the call to action button and to indicate scrolling behavior. If you like this type of content, you can watch other videos from the before and after series here.